Pontiac Fiero GT.
The new consensus with all those across the land who share a community of values
really exciting?
Embodied in these words: family, work, neighborhood, peace, and freedom.
The 1980s, remembered notoriously for its extravagance, brought us everything from colorful clothing, giant hair, video games, aerobics, minivans, camcorders, and talk shows. Although the decade began with double-digit inflation and the bright side, the U.S. Constitution had its 200th birthday, Gone with the Wind turned 50, E.T. phoned home, and in 1989, Americans gave $115 trillion to charity. At the very end of the decade, the Berlin Wall was removed. The 1980s brought us Michael Jackson, Michael Jordan, Madonna, Milli Vanilli, MTV, and another amazing phenomenon that doesn't plug in with an M.
In vitro fertilization.
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 Oh, you want to be born, don't ya? You want to be born and come out a real boy, huh? Yeah, that'd be nice. Aw, just a little spoon in a cup wants to be a real boy. How cute.
The first scientist to discover in vitro fertilization, or as it is known in the science world, IVF, was Dr. Patrick Septo. Dr. Septo and his associates expanded the borders of science while making a giant step in the process of reproduction. And on July 25th, 1978, Louise Joy Brown, the world's first successful test tube baby, was born. The public reaction wasn't great.
Test tube babies.
My baby's from test tubes? That's ridiculous.
So with this reaction, why did it happen at all? First of all, science is always progressing. So when they discovered a way for infertile couples who wanted to have children but could not do so naturally, science thought, why not? So what is IVF? Basically, IVF is the ability to start the development of a baby outside of the female body and then implant it or put it in a woman's uterus to grow fully. Although children born through the IVF procedure are sometimes referred to as test tube babies, the term is inaccurate. The phrase suggests that a baby literally grows inside a glass. This is far from the case. In fact, a test tube is not even used. Instead, the egg is fertilized by sperm in a petri dish filled with nutrients. So what makes a person infertile? There are a number of causes, such as blockage of the sperm ducts from STDs, the use of drugs, alcohol, and nicotine can alter the genetic material of sperm. For a woman, everything from scarring, blockage of the fallopian tubes, uterine tumors, and hormonal imbalances in ovulation. Step 1. Preparation of the eggs. The first step of the IVF process is to make sure that the woman's eggs are available and ready for fertilization. The couple watches for signs of ovulation and then... Step 2. Egg retrieval. A needle is sent through the vaginal wall into the ovary, where it begins to pull out the eggs that are found there. Thanks to the hormonal medication that helps the woman's body produce extra eggs, it is not unusual for a doctor to retrieve up to 30 eggs. After the eggs have been removed, an embryologist evaluates them. The eggs are then placed in a petri dish full of liquid that bathes and nurtures the eggs in the same way the woman's body would do. Step 3. Semen collection.
I'm just feeling weird about this. Honey, can you bring me a magazine, please? I'm trying to do the serum collection sample here. Ember, paying you $50,000 to impregnate you, thanks. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Now the male's sperm sample is prepared. The sperm sample is washed in a special liquid. In nature, this process is done by a woman's cervical mucus. In a lab, this wash does the job.
There's a lighthouse in the sound, wrestling with butcher girls. She don't ever change her clothes.
After the wash, the embryologist adds drops of semen to the dish. The dish usually contains around 50 to 100,000 sperm.
I can sleep inside a box 100 years. Lizards in the pressure zone. Mother knows it's only fair.
fertilized egg has divided between 4 and 8 cells, which takes place about 72 to 120 hours after the egg retrieval, the fertilized egg is called an embryo. Step 5. Embryo transfer. Now it is time for the newly formed embryo to be placed in the woman's uterus. An instrument called a speculum is inserted into the woman's vagina, and the embryos are drawn up into a small plastic catheter or tube. This portion of the procedure is often done in a dark, quiet atmosphere in order to help the woman relax.
Daddy told me on his dying day, give up your heart, but don't you lose your head. You come along, girl, what did I do? Lost my heart and my head went too. Lord have mercy. Little girl, you sure can cook. Little girl, you got me hooked. When you cook that chicken, save me the head. I should be working, but I'm home in bed. Dreaming about you. Love that gal. Love them chicken heads too. Without your love, like the Mississippi River, roll on and on. If loving you was a doggone crime, I'll be sitting in jail done flat 99. Thinking about you, dreaming about you. Love that gal, love them chicken heads.
After the procedure, the woman lies down for 2 hours. This gives the embryo a better chance to implant. Fun facts time. The cost of IVF often averages around $10,000. Very few health insurance programs cover either IVF or any other fertility procedure. There are currently an estimated 6.1 million infertile couples in the US. The average cost of IVF is between $8,000 and $13,000. Approximately 5% of infertile couples attempt IVF. The average success rate for the IVF procedure is 22.8%, although some clinics have reported success rates as high as 40%. In 2002, 50,000 babies were born worldwide through IVF. Now that we've seen how simple and effective the process is, why is it that books on the subject still have titles such as The Ethical Problem, Test Tube Babies, Illusion or Fantasy, In Vitro Fertilization, Blastocyst, Single Birth, Sex, Drugs, and In Vitro Fertilization, or How I Got Pregnant, Pregnancy Wishes and IVF Dreams, A Story and Lessons About Life, Love, and Infertility, and The Empty Picture Frame, An Inconceivable Journey Through Infertility? Why is it that some find it morally wrong? Well, it could be a concern of designer babies. Scientists have already discovered a way to destroy embryos with certain health conditions, such as Down syndrome or autism. But some question whether it is morally right to do so. Researchers worry that, as it becomes easier to alter the genetic material of embryos, some parents will start to request or reject certain traits. Perhaps they will want only blonde children with blue eyes. Maybe they will want to make sure that they have beautiful children. Some parents may only want a boy, others a girl. Some may even request a hermaphrodite,